Wang Chuqin, first game, Liang Jingkun to serve, love all.
Kim Youngju keeping everything straight as it should be. At least in terms of following up what you've already established. Wow. Fans. I mean, this is a really tough one to call. If I remember correctly, you might have even favored the other player with the touch.
Yeah. I mean, this time, I'll put my head on the chopping block in a way and say, yeah, I fancied Liang looking at this head-to-head. Even though Dato is the man when it's crunch time that he can crunch. I mean, look at the World Championships in Chengdu, right?
Oh, coming back against Shunsuke Togami from 4-9 down?
Yeah, I mean, that might be the most tense we've seen the Chinese fans in some time.
Absolutely. It is interesting to see how they go head-to-head. Liang Jingkun, remember the reason in 2019 that Fan Zhendong was not in the final. Beautiful flick to start it off from Liang Jingkun.
Yeah, for a big guy, he's got very good intricacy. It's almost a bluff with his physique. But of course, at this level, you have to have the ability to remove your opponent's ability to make the opening attack.
A tight serve here shuts down any chance to attack or push for that matter. Just control and waiting with the strong third ball over the table if he needs to. Liang Jingkun, well prepared, takes two-thirds of the first 6 points. So clean.
Yeah, so crisp. You can hear the contact, right? You talk about the sweet spot of Liang Jingkun's backhand.
It's an area code. It's this giant region.
I like the way you put that.
Thanks.
5-3.
So good investment in spin on this one. Wang Chuqin, normally, he's going... There she is. Wow. Letting the guy behind her have a little bit of freedom here, not controlling in that moment. You got to let your parents sometimes do what they want, you know? I was going to say that Wang Chuqin, for me, one of the things that makes him so dangerous is his fearlessness, the confidence that he takes these low drives with. But against Liang Jingkun from time to time, just investing in heavy spin like we see there. And placement, of course.
Let's fight for.
Pressuring that forehand, asking questions of Wang Chuqin's forehand recovery, which is usually amazing.
Yeah, it's impressive to me that Liang Jingkun can stay so close to the table in this rally to really drive Wang Chuqin behind. Catching the edge there, but taking his chances, going for the deep backhand. It's interesting to see when different players peak. Wang Chuqin obviously breaking onto the scene quite young at only 22 years old. I mean, he's been on the scene for some time. He's world number two now at 22. Although on the women's side, Xia Xia has been world number one for some time and even younger. Ooh, double happiness. The sponsor of the ball that just received double happiness, what we call it when it hits the top of the net and the edge of the table. Fortune at its finest. Nothing to be done there. The facial expression of Wang Chuqin. Watch. Still a chance? Nope.
Double devastation for him. You mentioned the world rankings. I can't help but think about Paris 2024, which I'm sure we'll talk about soon.
Six of the last eight for Liang Jingkun. He got up really quickly from that squatting shot to get back in the rally.
How early he takes it. That one a little bit later, and Wang Chuqin punished him for it.
And only barely, really. I mean, he was still catching the ball on the rise.
Yeah.
A
Five. What you define as early and late depends on where your body is. You know, when we say early, we mean in front of the body, and the body can be anywhere in the Infinity Arena when he plays a shot.
That's one way to use it. I think also just in terms of on the bounce, still taking the ball on the rise. Yeah, there are a lot of different ways, I guess, to use that word. It's interesting.
Yeah.
So two serves here. Wang Chuqin looking to tie it up.
Let six. Eight.
So confident that that ball hit the net on the way over. Just hits it down into his own side of the table to quickly stop the point.
Let
interestingly
six,
enough,
eight.
That the opponent, the server, Wang Chuqin, not seen it hit the net, and the umpire not seen it hit the net, he'd end the point losing it by doing that. So it's a risky thing to do.
Six.
But
nine.
I do think there's a lot of sort of fair play at the professional level, especially against teammates.
Yeah, there's no point hiding with all the cameras and people around.
Can't really do it. Da Pang, tough to hide. Extra spin slows it down a bit after this long, fast rally. Smart play, table awareness, court awareness, and peripheral vision to recognize how far back the opponent is to win this point.
Switched well and then got the opening. Didn't take his foot off the gas. The big man, Liang Jingquin.
So four game points now for the world number seven. Long push 11, with less spin six. Does it, 11-6. Back for game two, it's Wang Chuqin down 0-1. Outstanding play. For a guy who has taken off the attack in the early parts of this point, Wang Chuqin still found a way to get back in control here with that big backhand punch.
Long, good.
Pushes through with the backhand quite a lot, Wang Chuqin, I've noticed. It's not so, it's very wristy, but there's a lot of forearm before that happens.
Right, and a lot of forward motion as opposed to that brushing. Yeah.
Inside the end line, please outside. End line, onto end line, throw the ball.
I think that message is pretty clear. Do not toss the ball from inside the end line of the table, the baseline. And well handled, Liang Jingquin taking it. I think we don't see too much. I think at Ma Long's stage of the game, from time to time, there's a little more conversation. Cool shoes there, huh? Gotta love it. A little bit of chaos in the feet.
Footwork is just ever so important, isn't it? It all stems from that. If you're not in the right position to play a shot, how are you meant to build from that? Percentages drop so much.
Right, I couldn't agree with you more. This is part of the reason you can be as tiny as Deng Yaping, less than 5 feet tall, or Mima Ito, to be more relevant to today. You could be Liang Jingquin or Eugene Wang, not the slimmest guys in the world, but still just floating around on your feet, perfectly in position. Good spin, a little more shallow. What are you thinking?
Wang Chuqin is that good when he misses a forehand by that much, which isn't even that much. You are kind of amazed in a way.
It's also interesting that Liang Jingquin played that one as deep on the table. Normally from that position, you'll see Ma Long and a lot of the great minds playing that very shallow. So maybe a bit of surprise in the placement there.
Three, four.
Nice from Liang Jingquin. He baited in Wang Chuqin there. And then punished him. Wang Chuqin couldn't recover quick enough.
So a streak here, Liang Jingquin making his way back into this game. Is that four in a row from down 0-4?
I believe so.
It's all Wang Chuqin. Couldn't hear that one so clearly. It's always fun, though, when you have an individual shouting. And by always fun, I mean from where we're sitting, it can be entertaining. Timing is everything. A few of the players the other day had such big fan clubs that they were about to serve, and the fans were just so excited to see them play. players waited. Waited for their fans to finish.
Fight all.
So tied up again, 5 points apiece. Very low and spinny there. Liang Qingquan picking his place on the table, going wide. There's a sense of freedom right now in Liang Qingquan that just is allowing him so much racket speed and authority in these rallies.
Not for sure.
Display.
Love the stance, the low base. Also that classic, this is something the Chinese top players do so well, just dropping the racket behind their right thigh if they're right-handed.
Five, seven.
It's amazing.
It's also funny, when you think about the fan vote versus what you and I might have been talking about in terms of preparation. I mean, you were the one who really called it, but internally, Liang Qingquan has been so strong against teammates. 7 of the last 8 points for Liang Qingquan. We saw him come back against Lin Shedong. We've seen him beat Fan Zhendong under pressure. He's had some big wins against teammates. A lot of work for a point here. Wang Qiqin still looking for answers.
When Wang Qiqin is moving from forehand to backhand side, his ability to then play the backhand down the line absolutely amazes me. One of the best points of 2022 came against Ma Long. Think at the Summer Series where he did that. The only player to have, well, the best record against Ma Long is Wang Qiqin.
And here's a look at their percentage of points won on their serves. Liang Qingquan taking much more advantage of his serve there with nearly 60% and not even 40 for Wang Qiqin. That's incredible, the statement that makes about Liang Qingquan's receive game.
Float serve, difficult to flick. And it's his reliability against players outside of Team China, right? I mean, this guy, Liang Qingquan, two-time bronze medalist at the World Champs in singles. He's a big dog.
Nice turn to cover the middle here, Wang Qiqin. Again, he's got a full stroke forehand that's quite dangerous, but has to just reel it in here. Watch him take this forehand and finishes with the salute, just like he was in perfect position the whole time.
Yeah.
A lot of stress on that right leg.
It seems like such a suffocating serve to come up against in a way. That short topspin shovel into the forehand. Because it's hard to forehand flick something so short and low to the net.
And a beautiful follow-up backhand. You mentioned his backhand down the line and how strong it can be. After being beaten quite steadily in game number one, 11-6, Wang Qiqin with a massive comeback here has really turned things around, but it's going to come down to the finish line here in game two. Game point now for a 2-0 lead. Liang Qingquan's got a serve to do it. And remember, percentage-wise, the serves have favored him quite heavily. Backhand does it. Liang Qingquan backhands everywhere. 11-9. Social media, 9:30. Let me know.
One.
This is tough for Wang Qiqin. He would have really liked to have beat Liang so he can set up a clash with Lim Jong-hoon and try and get revenge from last year's Asian Cup. But Liang Qingquan has to press the reset button here.
Liang Qingquan meaning that he has to come back ready for a new game, can't rely on the fact that it's 2-0.
Exactly, he's up against an ever-present threat in Wang Qiqin.
Here, the Chinese team World champions in Chengdu. A beautiful sight. The stadium was electric there. Nice moment to have on a poster. So apparently 9:30 is not just a number, but playing Ma Long right now. He's playing the Ang Jing Quin. Beautiful exchange. You know, the short game, if what you said is exactly correct, which I wouldn't be surprised if it is, Wang Chuqin is getting out of the short rally quickly. And Liang Jingquan, even in the open rally, is just so quick to prepare the racket and generate power. Look at that backhand.
The point there, that's huge concern for Wang. Because, you know, if you aren't so good in the touch play compared to your opponent, you have to be amazing in the rally, and Liang's even winning that department.
That was incredible. Like a brushing, bending backhand, but low to the net. So side spin and top spin on it still. 5-1, he's up now. Beautiful forehand flick. The touch, as you mentioned, Liang Jingquan demonstrating there to keep it so short. And still, the follow-up attack, not easy. Nice half-long serve there. Just tempting Liang Jingquan to take the opening.
He still has his timeout remaining. Yeah. Yep.
You see how close to the back edge that was in the replay? Now, one thing I like about this for Wang Chuqin is that he's coming closer to the table. He's playing, as we would say, the more efficient stroke, the backhand, which is quicker to recover from. Just gaining that sort of advantage by staying near the table.
It seems like the player that comes along that stays so close is a bit of a trendsetter in some ways, and the game now has become closer to the table. Oh my word.
Back edge there, Liang Jingquan with a bit of fortune on the long serve. Wow. And a shovel serve, really. So one thing that's different, he's saying, man, where's my luck today? Rabbits still have feet. There must be rabbits' feet out there somewhere. How did they ever get in? That's a terrible thing. Right off the bounce, he drives in behind the table, keeps the topspin on. Wang Chuqin looking very different now in his tactics.
Man in the Li-Ning shirt with the Li-Ning forehand. Look at that. Looked off balance, but still played it on the line.
Mm.
7-5.
So second towel break here. Xiao John in the background. Wang Hao closest. Five. Team doctor, it looks like, far away. Physio, I guess. Not to be confused with the team doctor.
Now I see the coaches sat there. I can't help but think these are the kind of results that can add a bit of spice into the pot when you're trying to select two players for your Olympics team.
That's right.
7-6.
There's been an interesting history, as we don't have to go too far back to see a player who was kicked off the Chinese national team for insubordination came back to win the world championships at his first attempt, Zhang Jike. The spin on the parallel, big point here. Wang Chuqin trying to make his way back in, and Liang Jingquan not allowing.
Two men here who both received 3-month bans. Two men who like to prove a point. And Liang is on the verge of proving a massive one.
It takes so much out here. Wang Chuqin trying everything. Moves to the forehand to start that serve. Gets aggressive on the third and fifth ball, and still, it's not enough. Well prepared, keeping cool, and 2 points away from a clean sweep over the world number two. Jumping from behind the table. It's a short spin. He wanted to start. Liang Jingquan now with 4 match points. Corner to corner, though. Wang Chuqin staying cool and taking advantage of opportunity.
Swift play. Lovely timing. I love the screeches of the shoes on the floor you sometimes hear, all the minor adjustments made.
Yeah, me too, actually. Subtle pleasures. Simple pleasures. Outstanding rally to get that forehand into play. He was on his tippy toes trying to regain his balance, Wang Chuqin.
I love the reaction there of Liang Jingkun as well to say, fair play, bro.
That one had to reach out way in front. How wide the stance is once again. Just try standing like that. If you're at home after this game, try spreading your feet that like far apart. Just stand still. Don't even play table tennis for a minute. Continuing on through the timeout. 10-6. Three match points saved. What are you thinking?
This is epitomizing the reliability of Wang Chuqin to pull through the depths of despair. Can he do it here?
It is taken. Liang Jingkun with a massive win, 11-9. And a good hug out there, a little bro hug, handshake.